Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update is dedicated to the latest news about the constant magma inflow, and I'm starting with the different and sometimes conflicting opinions of experts that sometimes makes my work a bit harder or who to listen to, since scientists do not agree on how this will develop. And the Icelandic media has overall been seeking answers from numerous sources amongst scientists, because they know like me that there is no one official miracle geologist out there with all the correct answers. And we are looking at this unique event that no one saw coming. However, I do get it every now and then in the comment section that those scientists just don't know anything. I have listened to Icelandic scientists for a very long time, and I think that they generally know as much as can be expected of them, based on where the general knowledge stands, and we only know a part of the story, and that is what makes this such a fascinating subject. So the main task for scientists now is to gather as much data as possible for future generations, and I trust them to do so. But as for the status now, we have still significant magma inflow into the sill by the Blue Lagoon and the power plant. The land uplift is already more than before the events of November 10th, and when magma has filled up the space that it has access to, it will start to pressurize the surroundings, and that's when an earthquake start or even an eruption, but where? And now I have this interesting bit of information that I only picked up yesterday. According to Professor Magnus Tumi Guðmundsson, who is one of the extra careful experts when it comes to statements, he expects the eruption to take place where the dike is widest, by the old Sundahnjúkur craters, or where updraft was detected. And it is this updraft that got my attention immediately. And I wish that the media asked more about it, but I was thinking, did it detect gas there? Or did the university finally buy a thermal drone, like me? However, this might be the strongest indication I've heard about so far, and it's very logical to assume that the eruption will come up somewhere close by this updraft or opening. So now it's time again to remind you of this alternative tool for viewing earthquakes. It's based on raw data that is both good and bad, and so far most of the earthquakes have been detected at 4 to 5 kilometers depth. But yesterday I found a fairly dense earthquake spot with an unusual number of shallow earthquakes. This might not have to mean anything, but we just haven't seen so much of them yet. And since I learned about this updraft there, I sort of changed my focus point. And it is around here now. This is where those shallow earthquakes took place, and I've been trying to figure out where the lava would be flowing from here if an eruption occurs there. If it comes up on the east side of those craters and a bit further north, that would be the ideal location. But this could be wishful thinking, and the eruption could be large or the fissure would be long, and nothing we could do about it. However, we have to remain optimistic, and Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson was also in the news recently, and it's obvious that he's focusing more on the tectonics now, because we have never seen such displacement before. The land under the power plant at the Blue Lagoon moved 1 meter to the west and 25 centimeters to the north during the November 10th rifting event. So the Icelandic Land Survey has to make a new map, and this displacement is almost enough to show my car off-road in the GPS. So this displacement is just ridiculous. So we have already gone through a major event, and the fastest of its kind. And I'm not a scientist, but my guess is that this will end up with an eruption. And the reason is that this is the fifth event of this kind at this location. Something will give in at the end. It is clear that we have all the ingredients for a big eruption. And then we have this constant but stable land rise, and this significant magma inflow still. So my guess is that this will end up with an eruption, but it's impossible to say when. But I'm going to say December. And I have the feeling that we might have to wait for maybe 2 or 3 more weeks. And in the meantime, we could just as well get another magma run like November 10th, severe earthquake action, the whole package. But this is all very complicated since we have now those two magma storages, or this sill and a dike and this opening between them. And the sill is at 4 to 5 kilometers depth, and will it start to feed the dike again? That is at less depth. And there are experts saying that we got extremely close to an eruption during the November 10th event. The magma might have been just few hundred meters away from the surface. So the simple version is that all we need is a bit more pressure and off it goes. And strangely enough, an eruption would be a kind of relief that signifies that the people in Grindavík have at least some kind of closure inside. And after it, we can start a new chapter in the town's history. But overall, this is just a complicated and unprecedented situation. And before I stop today, I want to mention some of the other systems I haven't mentioned for a while. But it is a reason to do so. Like, it's noticeable on the seismometers that the last few weeks have been unusually quiet here in the north. Even this a huge fault. And that complete system has been extremely quiet since all this started on the Reykjanes Peninsula. Way less earthquakes than usual. But this is where this extreme fault comes up from the seabed, and I do have a complete video dedicated to this and linking to it. And I have noticed this trend before. When everything turns crazy in the south, even the most restless systems in the north are super quiet. But as for the last 2 weeks though, the tempo has been changing, like I've been seeing more earthquakes widespread on the peninsula. Not unusual locations, it's more and less the usual suspects. But this is no surprise since many of them might be triggered by the displacement by the Blue Lagoon. And it would not surprise me if something else would snap soon. And the other thing I noticed is this uptick in seismic activity by the Grímsvötn volcano under Iceland's largest glacier. And to make a long story short, this is one of the most powerful systems here in Iceland. Eruptions there are frequent but harmless, and I think I made 4 or 5 videos when Grímsvötn were just about to erupt. It turned out to be a teaser, but it's still a reason to be on the lookout. And I've been working on a video covering a devastating Laki eruption in 1783. It's the same volcanic system. This is the Laki fissure coming from the Grímsvötn volcano. So I have some good stuff in the making before Christmas. And best of all, scientists seem to agree on one thing at least. And it is that the risk of a volcanic eruption in Grindavík is decreasing. So finally, I had this little sample that I shot today during high noon in the high north, less than 100 kilometers away from Arctic Circle. And when I turn the camera south, it is as good as it gets when it comes to the sun. It barely makes it over the mountains. And it's getting cold. But I'm going to use those light conditions to the fullest this year. And the thermal drone, of course. So it's plenty to come. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.